Here it is, a big two-door coupe called the Monaro. On sale in Britain next spring from your Vauxhall dealer, sporting a price tag of £28,000. Being Australian, it's not the most elegant car in the world, and nor is it the most complicated. You get a limited slip differential, rear-wheel drive, and the same 5.7-litre V8 that you get in a Corvette. It's far from the most sophisticated engine in the known universe, but because it's so big, you can put it in six and pootle around at three, doing plenty of miles to the gallon. Or you can poke it with a stick. Then you will go from 0 to 60 in 6.5 seconds and reach a top speed of over 160, usually sideways. The rotary washing line, and now the rotary car. Now you might think this looks awfully dangerous, but it is Australian, remember, and they like a bit of danger. They've got wild dogs that eat babies for fun. They've got great white sharks. They've got box jellyfish. They've got snakes like crocodiles. And now they've got this, the red-backed, funnel-webbed car. For Europe, they have tweaked the chassis a bit, made it a bit more fun. And you can temper the lively rear end by turning the traction control on. But if you do that, the car sends out some very straight-talking Aussie messages. Let me show you what I mean.
What a poofter.
Backs to the wall, everyone.
There's a pom on board.
He's turned the traction control on.
What a poofter.
Poofter? You poof. What a poofter. My Sheila could go around the corner faster than this.
This does become wearisome after a while.
You hopeless pom.
Shut up!
And you got lucky in the rugby.
Shut up!
Poofter.
I'm going
poofter,
to turn it back.
Poofter.
Off again. There we are. And actually, that's no big problem because, despite appearances, this car really is a big friendly giant. Honestly, I have never driven a car around here that's just so easy at the limit. It's phenomenal. Right, floor in. Woo-hoo-hoo! And not just easy at the limit, it's also easy if you go beyond. Into that world of smoke and noise and looking where you're going, out of the side window. Slow in, brake, and ready. Side window, go down there. Big and simple, and I love it.
Waltzing Matilda, waltzing Matilda.
Think of it as a triumph of torque over intelligence. A cut-price BMW M5. A Jaguar XKR that's drunk. To be honest, the cameraman's not enjoying this very much, but I love it! It is a hooligan special. But it's not insensible. The seats are perfect. There's no other word for them. The driving position is spot on. The ride comfort is phenomenal for a car of this type. The space in the back for adults, and with a boot this size, you can even call it practical. Unbelievable. And when you bear the price in mind, it's also very well equipped. I've got cruise control, trip computer, fancy stereo, air conditioning, electric seats. Just about the only thing that's missing is satellite navigation. But then you don't need it, because like everything Australian, it knows exactly where it's going. Earl's Court.
pufta.
Of course, the big problem with this is, if you buy one, five of its mates will turn up with backpacks and want to live in your garage.
Yeah. Absolutely. Which is going
to
be...
Right, so obviously, I had to have a go in one of the faster versions. Imagine a Lotus Carlton and a Calibra Turbo coming together in a broom cupboard somewhere. This is the illegitimate love child that would result. It's got 440 brake horsepower. It does 0 to 60 in 4 seconds or so. It has fully adjustable suspension and it's arrived in Britain spoiling for a fight. So we thought we'd give it one. So, from the country that gave the world the rotary washing line, the Holden Monaro. And from the country that gave the world everything else, including Australia, actually, the supercharged Jaguar XKR. They both cost around £70,000, so this should be close. This should be epic. Hopefully, this should be Johnny Wilkinson and Elton Flatley all over again. The Jag got off to a flying start, but as the race progressed, the Aussie started to close the gap. Damn! I think I've won.
That is the first time I've ever heard anybody in a racing situation say that. Damn, I think I've won.
Yeah, well, did I win, actually? Can we just have a look at the...
I think you did.
Indeed, look, just by one sort of car's length. But anyway, let's move on from that small and lucky victory they had. Yes. The Cornwall. Where do we think...
Hold on a minute.
What?
Jeremy, all the Fords have moved to Sub-Zero. All of them.
Yeah, it's a fluid thing, the Cornwall. As you know, it's never anything fixed. And I thought, I looked at them, I thought, they're nice cars.
Really? I tell you what, they're moving back. It's that fluid. That's ridiculous.
Now, look, I want to make it absolutely plain. I'm not doing this. If anybody's watching from, like, Dagenham, I'm not responsible for that, OK? Let's move on. The Holden Monaro. Vauxhall Monaro, as it will be. What do we think?
Cool.
Well, I'm going to ask, I'm going to canvass the opinion of people who've dressed properly. What do you think?
Excellent. Cool, makes a nice noise.
Cool car, even though it's Australia. We'll give them a little something.
Well, they can't play rugby.
And you?
Coolish.
You think it's coolish? Okay, well, does anyone think it's not cool? Really? Well, let's come and have a word with this chap. Why is it not cool?
It looks like Knight Rider, 45 years on.
Yes, but you see, what I love about this car is it has no styling.
No. There's no pretensions about it.
And you know exactly, you don't have to explain anything with it. So I'm going to put it in the cool section, no doubt about it.
Okay, two more cars.